Welcome to another Rebel University video tutorial. This video will cover the features of Rebel's Kitchen Display System, or KDS, and how to customize the look and feel of your kitchen display. As with all of our tutorials, you can jump ahead to any topic that is most important to you. All of our videos have a table of contents listed below, along with other videos and support articles to help you along the way. Before we get started, it's important to note that kitchen displays are a paid add-on feature. If you want more information, please contact your sales associate. Also, in the management console, the Rebel Assistant can walk you through many of the settings from this tutorial. Just click the Need Help button at the bottom right and search for KDS or Kitchen Display. Then the system will walk you through setting up various functions. Or you can follow along with the next steps in this tutorial. Rebel's Kitchen Display System helps further expedite kitchen prep for your customers. Eliminating paper waste and improving the kitchen's speed of service ensures orders are fulfilled much more accurately and timely. Different visual options like tile views and color coding allow for smooth and efficient order flow. First, let's look at some of the settings you can use to optimize your KDS experience. To access KDS settings from the management console, navigate to Settings. Clear selections and type KDS in the search bar. Check the box to view all kitchen view and kitchen print options. There are many settings here. I'll highlight just a few. The color dining order options will color code your orders so that they can be packaged accordingly. Optimized KDS for coursing ensures courses only show on the KDS when they're fired back. If you'd like to be able to prioritize your orders, you can activate the order prioritization feature. This will provide an obvious notification to your kitchen staff. If they sort orders on the KDS by due date, you'll ensure orders are always prepped when they are due. For more info on this, see that article linked below. Review any additional kitchen display settings and save when finished. The last setting to point out is marking orders to be completed as soon as possible. To access this setting, clear selections and search for ASAP. Activate and save. Once this feature is turned on for an order, ASAP will display at the top of the order on the KDS. Just be sure to refresh the POS when you're finished with your settings. Now let's take a tour of the KDS. Depending on the current view that you have selected, if the menu options do not appear, you can double tap the top left corner for them to display and make changes to your KDS view. The options at the top of the KDS screen include All Day View, which allows you to toggle between seeing all orders from the day or just the current orders that are in progress. When All Day View is selected, you can drill down to see individual order details by clicking the arrow next to the order. Clear All will remove all orders from the current view, thus marking them as completed. You'll be prompted to confirm that you wish to clear all to finalize the process. Recall allows you to pull up previous orders that have been marked as complete. Group By allows you to select how you want orders to be grouped together on the KDS. You can choose from order, ticket, item, or time. Order By allows you to indicate if you want orders to sort by dining type. If so, then delivery orders would appear separate from dine-in orders or to-go orders. You can choose to display orders with the newest or oldest on top. With the Filter By option, you can choose to show all orders or select one of the dining options to display. This is useful in instances where maybe you have a driver station for your drivers and you only want to display delivery orders. Next up are KDS Views. KDS Views can be accessed from the Settings icon at the top right. This is password protected, so a manager needs to enter their PIN or the default PIN to proceed. The first option, Expedite, will display all items that are sent to the kitchen. This option must be used in conjunction with a separate kitchen display for cooks. When selecting any of the view screens, other settings are available, such as what order details you'd like to include, how combos display, and more. Be sure to check out the articles below for more details. The next view option is Tile Expedite. This is similar to the standard Expedite screen, but displays each order in a tile format. As with the Expedite option, the Tile Expedite option must be used in conjunction with a separate kitchen display for cooks. Tile Kitchen and Kitchen View displays the items that need to be prepped by the cook. This is normally placed near the chefs so that when chefs mark items as complete in real time, it will cascade to the Expedite screens. Similar to Expedite and Tile Expedite, the same info will appear, just in either a tile format or a line format. The Order Display view shows all current orders awaiting completion. This is normally used as a customer display to show customers when their order is complete. Rotating images can be placed onto the left for visual effect or advertisement of specials, happy hour, etc. If you have a unique kitchen flow and need certain items to be bumped from one display to another, you can use kitchen flows. This is something you can work with our professional services team to configure. Check out the link below for more info on this service, or you can contact our support team. Once the kitchen flow has been created, you'll need to assign products to it. To assign products to a kitchen flow, from the management console, navigate to Products. Select the desired product by either searching for it or using the product tree. Click the pencil icon to edit the product details. Use the clear selections at the top left and search for Printers. From the search results, check the box next to Printers. Then, on the right side of the screen, click the field next to Printers. Here, you'll see your individual kitchen printers and displays, along with the new kitchen flow. Select only the KDS flow from the list. You do not need to select the individual kitchen displays. Save when finished, and be sure to refresh your point of sale for the changes to take effect. Users can also update product details using our import-export function. Just choose the Advanced Product Export and be sure to activate the Printers column on the sheet. For each product, you can fill in the preferred printer or kitchen flow. For more info on importing products, please check out that video. Now, let's see how this works on your iPads. First, you'll ring in a product on the point of sale. Be sure that this product has been assigned to a designated kitchen flow or KDS. Within the order, you can set the entire order to be ready as soon as possible by tapping the order number at the top of the page. Or you can prioritize an individual item on the order by first adding the item to the order. Then tap the item from the order on the left. Select Prioritize from the pop-up window. This will send that item to the kitchen immediately for them to begin prep. When finished adding the rest of your items, tap Send or Hold depending on your settings. In this example, the product will go to two KDS screens, KDS 1 and KDS 2. The item will appear on both screens. However, on KDS 2, the status will show as waiting. This will remain until KDS 1 completes their portion of the order. When Chef 1 marks their items as complete, the status will change on KDS 2. Now, instead of it saying waiting, a complete button will appear for that cook to select once their items are ready. Once the second chef completes their part, they will mark it as complete, which will complete the entire order. Now, the second chef can notify the server that the order is complete. There are lots of new KDS features being released regularly, so be sure to check out those associated features in the links below. We hope you found this tutorial helpful and were able to follow along to complete the necessary steps. Thanks for watching another Revel University video tutorial.